You have 3 seconds to attract attention. Go!
Screaming a racial slur, mocking Chinese tourists,
red dragon, huh, Beijing,
dropping his pants.
I'll make you a homosexual. You drop that gun right now, USA.
Georgia state lawmaker Jason Spencer did all that and more as he talked with a supposed Israeli anti-terrorism expert. The governor called it appalling and offensive. The state House Speaker reprehensible and called for Spencer's resignation. But he says he was tricked by deceptive and fraudulent behavior by a company that exploited my state of mind, his fear of terrorism, because that expert was really comedian Sacha Baron Cohen of Borat fame.
My name is Borat.
Who's shooting an episode for his new TV show, Who is America? And Spencer is not the only one who has been taken in.
Are his stunts exposing truth or just pushing an already polarized country farther apart? Many of the victims have been speaking out. So far, they include Sarah Palin, Dick Cheney, Ted Koppel.
With some saying they never knew the true purpose or person behind their interviews.
He gets people to say stupid things because he lies to them.
Sarah Palin, whose episode has not aired yet, says she was lured by the promise of an interview about veterans. Quote, I joined the long list of American public personalities who have fallen victim to Cohen's evil, exploitive, sick humor. Defending her, James O'Keefe, the conservative activist who has used hidden cameras and deceptively edited videos to embarrass liberals. He tweeted at his past critics, to those who praise Cohen's posing as a disabled vet to sting Palin, you can go straight to hell. But there is a difference.
This is a situation where people are saying and doing really outlandish things while they know there's a camera on them. And I think that that ratchets up the heat on them significantly.
Just remember to point Puppy Pistol's mouth right at the middle of the bad man.
Nonetheless, conservatives clearly feel targeted, even when they resist.
You want me to say on television that I support 3- and 4-year-olds with firearms?
And even as Cohen skewers progressives, too.
Well, if you put everybody into the 1%, they wouldn't be the 1%.
Well, no, it still would be.
No, it wouldn't.